Hi, I'm Mike Marin, and in this video, we're going to talk about the difference between R and RStudio. I get it asked a lot, do I need to download and install RStudio? Well, my answer to that would be no, but should you install RStudio? Definitely. So what is RStudio? It's a free, open source, integrated development environment, or IDE for R, the statistical programming language. So what does that mean? Well, basically, RStudio helps keep R a bit more organized, and it also adds a lot more functionality, mainly through menus. But instead of me saying a bunch of words, let's take a look at R, and then we'll take a look at RStudio. If we open up R, we can see the console here. Now let's create a vector X that's using the numbers 1 to 5. Let's also create a vector Y that's the numbers 6 to 10. And let's make a plot of y versus x. You can see here that the plot pops up in a separate window. Mine is a bit too large by default, and I would need to resize it in order to have the plot look a little bit nicer. Also, if we want to know what's in R's working memory, we have to ask for this. We can do so using the ls command, and this lets us know that R sees these objects x and y in its memory. We can see up here that R does have some menu options, although if you take a look and scroll through these, you'll notice that they are pretty limited. Now, let's take a quick look at RStudio. So we can go here and open up RStudio. You can see the console here, along with a few other windows. Again, let's create a vector X, that's the numbers 1 to 5, and let's create another vector Y, that are the numbers 6 to 10. First, you can note that we can see what's in R's working memory up here. Now, if we take a look at a plot of x versus y, you can see that it appears here in this window. If we want to save the plot, we can click on this export tab here, and then we can save as an image. And here we can see there's lots of different options for the file type we can save as. We can also change the height or the width of the plot through here. We can also do this manually if we'd like. Here's the file name we're going to give it, the directory of where we'd like to save the plot. So let's just cancel this. Importing data into R also becomes easier. While you can still import data using commands like the read.table command, you can also import data using the import data set tab here. We can select from a local file, that means it's saved on our computer. And then using these menus, we can select the data set we'd like. Here we'll load in the LungCap data. And you can see here's the name we're going to give to our data set in R. We also get a preview down here of what the data is going to look like. And once we import this data set, you'll see it pops up here and we get a data view. And we can play around with the data a bit to look at it here. For example, if we'd like it to be sorted by lowest to highest lung capacities or highest to lowest lung capacities. So this can give us a quick view of our data. We can also easily create and manage scripts within RStudio. If we go here to File, and then New File, and a new R script. So let's create and submit a few new commands here. I'm going to create a new variable, and we're going to create Z, that are the numbers 11 to 15. And then we're going to add up X, Y, and Z. So we'll sum X, Y, and Z, and let's submit those commands. Let's submit that here. We're going to create that new vector X, and then we're going to sum x, y, z. And then we could, of course, go ahead and save this file. And this is going to allow us to save that script so that we can reproduce our analysis on any given day. You can, of course, work with a script directly in R and not RStudio, but working this way within RStudio is a lot simpler and more user-friendly. You can also see here, if you create a new file in R Markdown, what Markdown does is it allows you to embed R code and R output directly into documents, slides, PDF documents, HTML, Word documents, and many more. You can also see under the menu here, you have this Create New Project. Now what this does is it allows you to manage all of your files and output related to a project in one spot. Now I'll leave it to you to explore more of the menu options that are built into RStudio. The point of what I've been trying to show you is that while RStudio is not absolutely necessary, it makes the user experience of working within the R programming language much, much nicer. To me, it's a no-brainer. If you're going to work with the R programming language, work within the RStudio environment. You'll be happy that you did. Thanks for watching this video, and to learn how to code in R, follow along with our series of R tutorials designed specifically for the beginner who is new to the R software. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel, like us on Facebook, and visit our website.